flavor of the week? Xylazine?
Find out today on Medical History Mysteries.
Everybody, welcome to Medical History Mysteries. I'm Pam Maragliano-Muniz with my fave, Tom Viola.
How's it going, Pam?
Hey, we are continuing our coverage on cocktails. And this week, we're talking about xylazine, mixing xylazine with heroin and xylazine and fentanyl. That sounds like a crazy combination. Can you tell us about that?
You know, I've been talking about xylazine for about 3 years now. And just recently, I've started to see more and more information about it out there, not just on dental sites, but also out there for sites devoted to giving general public information. And xylazine is a veterinary tranquilizer. It's designed basically for horses, but I've seen it used in other small animals as well. It's combined with heroin and fentanyl to increase the euphoric effect of both heroin and fentanyl, but also to prolong the duration of action, if you will, the duration of the time period in which you're under the influence of both drugs. Now, we all know we're under the umbrella yet of this opioid epidemic. And a lot of people ask me, where did fentanyl come from? I thought everybody was using heroin. Really what it boils down to is logistics. Heroin is big, bulky, it weighs a lot, and it's hard to transport. Fentanyl, by contrast, only requires microgram doses. So it's very small amounts of very light powder, which are very easy to conceal. So just from that basis alone, and the fact that, of course, fentanyl is way more potent if you're talking about microgram doses, a little goes a long way. So it's kind of obvious when you look at it that way that fentanyl would become the standout of illicit opioids. The problem with fentanyl is it lasts a fairly long time, but when you're done with your dose of fentanyl, there's no immediate craving to use fentanyl again in some patients. What if I could add something that would prolong the effect, or at least prolong the effect as you see it? Well, why wouldn't I add xylazine, this veterinary tranquilizer, that would keep me in this tranquilized state longer than the fentanyl would on its own? Well, what happened then is I've been under the influence of the xylazine fentanyl combination for so long that when it finally wears off, I'm ready for another dose. That keeps, I hate to say it this way, customers as repeat customers. I've used your type of fentanyl before. Wow, was I under the influence for a long period of time? I'm going to try it again and again. Problem, of course, is fentanyl causes nasty side effects. Whenever you talking about fentanyl, you're talking about respiratory depression. Now add xylazine, which causes nasty side effects, like, you know, the potential for being essentially unconscious almost, if you will, for that whole period of time. You can become a victim to a predator. You can become a victim of crime. And now your craving for opioid increases. So this is worsening the opioid epidemic. And if you inject it, well, xylazine, when it's injected, causes horrific sores in your skin, which could lead to very bad infections and ultimately even amputations, which we're seeing in some silly cities, particularly Philadelphia, as you know, of all the cities that I can think of, is under the most problematic behavior when it comes to the use of xylazine because it's so widespread in the city. And so there's the issue with behavior and people doing things that they shouldn't be doing, but there's also the ER admissions for people who are under the influence of xylazine and fentanyl, didn't even know they were getting xylazine, and then have to suffer these medical complications along with it. So I wanted the viewers to be aware that your patient, again, just like we talked about with carbamazepine and cocaine, your viewers may be made aware by their patient, yeah, occasionally I'll do heroin, occasionally I use fentanyl, but they may not be aware that their patient's also getting xylazine. And what if a patient used fentanyl and xylazine to take the edge off before they came to see you in the dental office because they're having dental anxiety? Well, now if I give them anything that can increase their risk of respiratory depression, I've tremendously increased their risk of respiratory depression because of the additive effect, as we like to talk about. And so these people may not be good candidates for an opioid analgesic or conscious sedation. However, all of that relies on them telling me, I've had this dose of fentanyl and xylazine either right before I walked in here or even maybe a few hours ago. So again, the point of all this is to make our viewers aware of the potential complications. And there's so much more we can get into about the very bad effects of xylazine, but that's just a primer. And I encourage everybody to do more research, especially on the incidence and the frequency of xylazine use in your area.
Wow, that is insane. So if you have xylazine mixed in with heroin or fentanyl, will Narcan not be as effective?
Well, that's what that was one of my last points I was going to bring up, but I'm glad you brought it up first, because if I'm a dental professional, I've been told, hey, you can always use Narcan to reverse respiratory depression from opioids. Heck, if I'm a New York State dental prescriber, I am obligated, and other states have this too, obligated to prescribe Narcan along with an opioid prescription. Narcan is now available over the counter. You can buy Narcan. If I'm a patient who uses fentanyl, I'm always going to keep Narcan around just in case, right? Guess what? There have been several instances where the combination of fentanyl and xylazine made the Narcan ineffective or not as effective in reversing the effect of the opioid. So that's another cause of concern for us, because we always feel we can use Narcan as a last-ditch emergency, you know, rescue agent. But it may not be as effective in patients who use xylazine along with it.
Wow, that's sad. Well, thank you so much for creating awareness around this topic. Again, this was a new one for me. I'm pretty sure this was a new one for a lot of people around us. Are there any final thoughts about this?
Yeah, I think it goes back to, again, your patient admitting that they're using fentanyl and xylazine. But again, I think it boils also down to whether or not the patient even knows they got xylazine with their fentanyl. The common practice among some people who provide this drug is that they add xylazine in very small doses to begin and work their way up so that you become more and more addicted to the product, so you'll buy it from them and nobody else. So they may not even know that xylazine is in their fentanyl and or heroin combination.
Wow. Scary.
Absolutely. Wow.
Okay, well, I look forward to, do I look forward to talking more cocktails next time? I don't know. This is kind of scary and sad, and just like my heart goes out to the users and the families of the users out there, because I know that it's certainly a struggle, and it's, you know, we're seeing lives lost, and it's just, it's a shame. And so thank you for spreading awareness of this. We're going to talk one more cocktail for you next week, and I look forward to seeing you then.
Thank you, everybody. Take care.